Guess what I have? That was a fail. Yes. Logo. So I printed a box and it looks pretty cool, but I think I might have printed like a bit way too much support. But luckily I have my weapon. Let's see. Okay, so I ran out of oil, so I went and got another bottle of oil, but I accidentally broke the top of it. So now I want to transfer all the oil in here into this bottle, but I don't want to make a mess while pouring it. So maybe I can 3D print a funnel. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, so I downloaded a funnel. Let's print this. The funnel is printing. It's gonna take a while. Okay, it is done. Cool. Let's take off the support and see if it works. Cool. Okay, so hopefully this doesn't make a mess. Let's see. Okay, I'm gonna have to hold it here by hand because it doesn't go all the way in. And I did it without making a mess. Cool. So, a very interesting thing arrived. This is a roll of wood filament. Well, it's not actually wood. It's mostly PLA, but with wood dust mixed in. But based on what I've read about this, you can make it look a lot like wood, just with some finishing and some sanding. But this is cool. This filament really does have like a wooden texture. I can feel kind of like the roughness. It feels pretty much like wood or cardboard. It also feels a bit like cardboard. It's very interesting. It makes me wonder how this thing would even melt. So I just printed a chess piece with the wood filament. It actually looks pretty cool. So I don't know, maybe if I'm bored enough, I might just go and get my hands on some wood finishing and see how it looks. Okay, so I used the wood filament to print something cool. No, that's not it. This is. So, it looks pretty light and not a lot like wood yet, but I ordered some wood finishing, some sandpaper, and some wax, and I think I can get this thing to look a lot like real wood. Now, they've just arrived, so let's go get it. Alright, so here I have some wood stain and some sandpaper. Let's get started. Okay, now this thing is being sanded, let's get painting. I'm gonna hold it a bit further away from me because I don't think you're supposed to breathe this thing in. Alright, it's looking pretty nice so far, so let's continue. Yeah, this is actually pretty fun. I haven't painted in quite a while. Alright, I'm just gonna leave it here to set for a while, and I'll come back in, yeah, a while. Alright, now this is looking pretty good, and it feels nice and dry now. So I'm gonna start applying the wax on the top to give it a kind of like a more shiny look. Let's see. Alright, let's let this sit for sometime. All right, here's the final product. You can barely tell that it has been 3D printed. This looks pretty cool. I might do more of this later with some other more complicated shapes. But this looks cool. Don't know what I'm gonna use it for, so I'm just gonna, I don't know, find somewhere to put it, I guess. All right, so I'm currently taking this class called Computer Architecture, and it's mainly about like really getting into the nitty-gritty of computers and programming and stuff. And right now we're learning this language called MIPS, which is one of the assembly languages that looks very weird, but is pretty cool. So this is what it looks like. As you can see, it barely looks like human language. All the green parts are my comments. If I don't have those, I won't know where I am in the program. So the thing about MIPS and other assembly languages is that there is literally no more magic compiling anymore. At this level, the language is pretty much directly communicating with the hardware. Anyways, that's enough MIPS introduction. What I was going to say is that we have this assignment where we had to complete this task in language. And I finished the problem okay, and it passed all the test cases, as you can see. However, the professor also started this competition where they want the code that has the least number of instructions. So anyways, there's this leaderboard thing on the submission site where it ranks people's code by how many lines they have. So the fewer you have, the higher up the rank you are. So I originally wasn't gonna try to compete, but then I submitted it and I noticed that my code is actually like, I guess shortest. I don't wanna say most efficient because it might not be the most efficient, but it's simply like, it's the shortest except for the TA's code. So I'm second place here and I was pretty happy about that. And then like, I just had my code. And I thought it was fine, you know, like I don't have to like try to beat the TA and stuff. Like his code is actually a lot shorter than mine, so I probably wouldn't be able to. But then today, I had a look at leaderboard and somebody has beaten me by 3 lines. So now I'm gonna go back to my code and I'm gonna try to reduce it somehow so that my code is shorter than his. Okay, so I played around with this code a bit and it turns out that there were some redundant bits in the program. So now I have reduced that and let's see. All right, now my code is back in second place beneath the TA's code and I am 3 lines fewer than that person who had previously beaten me. So hopefully nobody else beats me. I have been thwarted again. Someone else came up and his name is just like, his name is literally a question mark. I don't know what it is, but anyway, someone else came up and beat me by 3 lines again. So now I have to go back to the code and fix it. It's like the third time I completely like redid the thing. So I don't know what else I can remove. You see, the main issue with this code is that I have to also follow calling conventions for each of the registers I use. Every time I use a register outside of my main block, I have to save it, and that takes up lines because I have to say, save this thing. Okay, I have a hunch on how I can beat this person, but it does kind of involve pretty much like restructuring the entire code. All right, so I have restructured my entire code yet again. I basically cut all the functions that were out of main and shoved them into main in order. So now my main function is like absurdly long and very confusing. I added as much like comments as I could so that I can understand what I'm writing and whoever's reading this can hopefully understand what I'm writing. And also I added this huge block of comments in the beginning for like the professor or whoever's gonna read this, explaining that this code is messy not because I don't know how to code, but because I'm trying to get the job done in the fewest number of lines possible. And I think I have eliminated a bunch of lines, like at least like 10 to like 15 lines. I hope that this is the last time I have to do this. All right, let's submit this and see. Okay, I just submitted this and guess what? I beat the TA. I beat the TA by like 7 points, 7 lines. Yes. All right, that was like, what, like 10 hours well spent?
You know what? I feel like a god right now. I'm gonna put this 3D printing scaffolding as a crown.
You should see me in a crown.
Stay.
I'm gonna run, there's nothing to help. Watch me make them bow.